Let's set up slot one. Save slot one for flat down on the ground. Hello everyone, welcome to my first episode of the second season for Let's Play Dead Cells. So the elemental update has become available to the public. So we're going to start a new game and proceed, and hopefully they've fixed all the crash bugs and whatnot. So we're going to do our first run through and see how well the update does now that it's more or less official. You can no longer die. I still don't understand. Huh, what others? Must be talking about himself. Like other people like him. Grab ourselves the starter shield. Block that, block that. Block him. Take out that guy. We need to go up here. Block. So far, so good with the shield blocks. Yeah, they still got it to where the shield does not interrupt your sword swing. So if you're in the middle of swinging your sword, you cannot pull out your shield. Like the animation for swinging the sword. Our first teleporter. Second teleporter. We're not ready for that yet. Bonus chest. Got our level 2 ice grenade. Don't really need to do that. We'll hop down here. Can't rub that yet. So, we'll go ahead and start working our skill ups. Take care of that shield, dude. We don't have any money yet. Not enough, anyway. Push the wrong button. Got ourselves a bear trap. Huh, so that what made... so when they thaw out, they bleed extra life. Pretty good. Do we want to do a whip? What's the damage in this? 119, yeah. Oh, wow. It made that guy jump down. I wonder if he fell. It didn't used to do that. Mad early on that one. Got the blood sword. Teleporter. Promenade. I think that's about it for this level, as far as the stuff we can access. Yeah, we needed to get the vine to go up there. There's a grenade there, but we don't have the thing for it. I think there's a vine there as well. Looks like the promenade's all we got. So we should be able to unlock the potion, I think. Yep. Got our blood sword there. Unlock our potion. Retain some of our gold. Then we will spin the last bit in unlocking the blood sword, I guess. Prisoner, huh? Still makes me wonder what exactly I am in prison for. Dude, loading screens like this is where the memory error would happen, and you would just crash out of the game. So, a grenade 2. I guess we can replace the bear trap. Go ahead and grab our assassin blade. Keep wanting to block with the shield and forgetting to throw the shield. Well, I blocked something. Not entirely sure what it was that I blocked. At least that's doing damage. I missed again, yep. I'm not entirely sure if that's set up that way so you can roll to avoid damage. Well, you don't take damage, but avoid the stun, I mean. So far, so good. Let's not jump on any spikes. Get ourselves a strength upgrade. Now we can't afford anything else. Teleport back up. Take out that guy, grab that. Probably do a skill up on it. So far, so good. Oof. Lucky jump there. Got our bonus chest. Ooh, the Firebrand. Man, this thing's tempting. I really like using a shield, though. You know what? I'll grab this until I get a... something better than that shield. Yeah, if we get, like, well, I don't think I have any shields unlocked yet, so... But I really like the Firebrand. Oh, hit me through the floor. Are you not gonna teleport up here? Oh, see, I forgot I don't have the shield anymore. We have one charge on our heal, so we'll go ahead and use that. Damage reduced by 10. Long dive attacks cause the ground to ignite. That'll work. Now, I halfway don't even want to pick that up. Because usually when you unlock the Spartan Sandal, what ends up happening is it becomes the only item you get for your starter items. And it's terribly annoying. It made the fire a lot more pronounced. I remember it was like... It didn't really, It went into the water and still set the stuff around it on fire. So here's our elite guy. Shit, wrong way. So we got the vine rune now. This rune permanently gives you the ability to regrow or grow climbable vines, which is right here. They changed that too, so you can see them a lot better now, at least when they're grown. So this goes to the ramparts. We're just going this way for checking for skill ups. Well, there's a heal. No, I want the heal. So let's... Not really getting any closer. Can we eat it from this side? Yes, we can. Okay. Good, because we totally tanked that dude. Yeah, this is the ramparts. If I wanted to just... So I might be able to get to the sewer, which is to get to the next rune, which would be, so there's another kebab there. So that would be here. arrows. Couldn't see him. There, it doesn't set them on fire if they're in water, so that's something good to know. It also doesn't set them on fire if it directly hits them. Oh, weird. Was not setting the ground on fire, so they have that tethering thing. So, like, the turrets and stuff won't work if you're not close to them, so... Throwing knife? Nah. Got some cells for 6,000. Don't have 6,000, so I'll pass on that. We'll head up to the old sewer since we already explored everything else. And now we will cash in our rewards. Unlock that. Let's see, we can do more gold or more potion. Let's do potion. Okay, so 100% damage on a burning target, 25% damage on a stun target. Recharge our potion. We'll head into the old sewers here. This is where the next rune is, the one that lets you rub the little sarcophagus. They added this in there. Basically, it's the story for why you're going after the rune. Set up in a very Smeagol kind of way with my precious. Mushrooms up there. Don't like it. Don't like it at all. So they got burnt to death. I'm up here. Oh, there was a rune right there, and I jumped into the... I can only imagine what that is. I mean, I'm in a sewer, so some sort of sewer water. Money. Got our big ball and chains here. Mushroom up there we need to get rid of right away. Those guys are pretty straightforward. Let's head up here. Grab ourselves another health upgrade. We're up to level 3 on that. That was a dead end. Ugh. That was pretty painful. There's an elite, not the elite that we need. A grenadier. Oh, that's not a grenadier, that's the jumping kind. Oh, we're gonna get comboed. Damage taken reduced. Poison enemies that hurt you. I don't know. Maybe. Not really doing the fire, setting the ground on fire thing, so maybe. Used our health potion, so now we're in a bit of a tight spot here. So far, so good. So we might end up not making it to that guy. Go! I don't like the fact that you get stuck by those guys. When they're coming out of the ground, you can't move past them. They're considered already up. Like, they're not even out of the ground yet. You can't move past them. It's a little wonky. Oh, man. Hey, look. Balance blade instead of the blood sword. I don't know. I think I'll hold off on it for now. Can't use that yet. There's a teleport over here. There's a greed shield. Go back up here, check that far end. Jumped on that dude. So we got ourselves a better ice grenade. Oh, there's our... Pretty much already decided that I'm not going to be able to make it past there without getting hit. Unless I can find some kind of kebab. I pushed the button for the grenade, but he did not throw it. Controls are fairly decent. Yeah, look, you can't even do damage to him when he's coming out of the ground. I need some food. Not really need, don't need strength, I need food. There, Need a rune inside the wall to reveal some food, please. Can I just maybe get lucky and find something sitting on the ground over here? Obviously no. What is this one? Three times, flashbang, throwing knife, firebrand. Damn, my guy's limping because he's all wounded. Those birds are so bad. This torch throws an arrow to the front as well as at an angle upwards. Place that grenade with that grenade. Man, what I wouldn't give for a snack right now. Ice grenade, victims suffer bleed, frost related, nah, nope, nope, nope. We are looking for food. How's that go? Warrior needs food. All the damage you take is also dealt to nearby enemies, drops a bomb when you roll. Could be useful, but I think I will take my chances. Skill up. That's probably the worst situation I could be in right there. Maybe I can... There we go. Yeah, when you have a ranged weapon to use on those guys, they're not too bad. So we already went this way. So far, I haven't seen any runes yet either. Got ourselves a thing there. We can go to the Black Bridge. A new blood sword. So damage on a frozen target. Works pretty good with the ice grenade. But we don't have anything that, like, heals us. So let's check back here and see if we can go up there. Maybe we'll get lucky. Let those pop off. So there's nothing in here. Nothing in there. Well, that's kind of neat. You can break the little background stuff. I didn't notice that before. Good thing there's no falling damage, or I'd have fell to my death right there. Okay, it looks like we can go down here. To a bear trap. Oh, my dude's bleeding everywhere. So it looks like only thing that's left, make an attempt on getting the rune. Do we have any? We don't have any blueprints, so we don't really have to worry about losing too much. I think it was here. Yep. So maybe we'll get really lucky. I feel like that's a big old note. Oh, got killed by his minions, or him slicing me at the back. Back already? Well, doesn't seem to be going all that well for you. Yeah, this is where he basically is telling you that the world is procedurally generated. Alright, so that's going to do it for this episode. If you liked it, click the like button. Leave comments in the comment section down below. Check the description for links and ways to support my channel. I'll see you guys in the next episode.